Hey, Devlin First. Welcome back. So yesterday we had the chance to kind of look at the Jews' Babylonian exile from Jeremiah's perspective. And today I really want to dig into the don'ts of living in a time of exile, right? So today we're going to be talking about don't fight it. And Jeremiah wrote this letter to the exiles, and we find it in Jeremiah chapter 29. You probably recognize this chapter, right? We hear about Jeremiah 29 a lot. And today we're going to be looking at verses 5 through 9. So as we begin with don't fight it, I want you to read along with me verses 5 through 7. Build houses and settle down. Plant gardens and eat what they produce. Marry and have sons and daughters. Increase in number there. Do not decrease. Also, seek the peace and prosperity of the city to which I have carried you into exile. Pray to the Lord for it, because if it prospers, you too will prosper. So, what I mean by this, don't fight it, is exactly what Jeremiah is telling the exiles here. Settle in, get comfy, figure out how to make it work, because we could be here for a while, right? And one of the temptations that has always plagued God's people is this temptation to have this overly escapist mindset, right? We want to move on to glory. We want to move on to when we're at home at last, right? And we are called to be set apart. We are called to be different. We are called to be aliens in a foreign land. But that can't mean that we fight our exile so hard that we forget to settle in and live where we are, right? Jeremiah tells the exiles to do all these things that you would do if you were at home in your comfort zone. He says, you know, marry, go ahead, start a garden, start a farm. Do the things that take generations long, right? Because it might look different, but we gotta figure out how to make it work. We've got to figure out how to make it work because we might be here a whole generation, right? He's saying to the exiles, we might be here from one generation to the next. And unfortunately, some of you may die here. Some of you may only live on through your kids here, right? And so as the church, we also need to figure out how to settle into this new normal, right? It's so weird and it's so different, but we have to figure out how to make it work. Me bringing you these words today online is an example of that, right? So a few months ago, I never would have imagined recording and doing these devotions for you so that you can come back and watch them online. But this is what we have adapted. This is how we have adapted, because the church is not only found inside these walls, right? It's not only found when we come into this sanctuary, because the church is not the building. We have to find new ways that God has already paved for us to be his body, to live out the church, right? To be the church. So now I want to read verses 8 and 9. Jeremiah says that God told him, yes, this is what the Lord Almighty, the God of Israel, says. Do not let the prophets and diviners among you deceive you. Do not listen to the dreams you encourage them to have. They are prophesying lies to you in my name. I have not sent them, declares the Lord. So once again, Jeremiah is telling them, listen, don't fight it, right? Our first instinct is either gonna be fight or flight. And if we're in a place that we don't wanna be, we want to fight it. We wanna run away. We wanna get out of that situation. And the false prophets, honestly, were just telling the people what they wanted to hear. They were just letting them believe that the word of God was not really what God was saying, right? So they were deceiving the people. And we don't want to fight it. We don't want to let the false prophets woo us into this false sense of security, right? That this will all be over soon. We saw how Hananiah said, oh, it's only gonna take 2 years and then we'll all be back home. And we want so badly to say, oh, it's all over, it's all in a downward swing, right? We want so badly for it to be over. I do too. But we can't let anything woo us into this false sense of security that it's over before it's supposed to be, before it lives itself out, right? We have to allow God to work in His own time. We have to let Him guide us to the work that He has already prepared for us, because we are joining Him in His work. And He has prepared all of these things for us in this time where we are uncomfortable, right? He has made it possible for us to record this exact devotion, right? He has made it possible for technology to come so far that we can adapt and we can change in new ways that we never imagined. And there are so many more ways that He has paved for us that we have to just look and seek and figure out where God is leading. So I want you to join me again tomorrow as we continue with Jeremiah chapter 29, verses 10 and 11. And we're going to be talking about don't despair. So we don't want to fight it, but we also don't want to get caught up in despair, right? So let's pray together. Dear God, we just thank You so much. We thank You once again that You have provided these words. God, we know that they were in a time of exile, and God, we see a little bit of that here and now. God, things are so different, they're so weird, they're so agonizing at times, and God, I just pray that You would continue to be with us. Strengthen us, help keep us from fighting it, Lord. Help us to not fight against this time and to allow You to work, allow You to show us how we can be Your body. In Your name we pray, Lord. Amen.